Welcome back to an introduction to evidence-based undergraduate STEM teaching. This week, we're going to continue our exploration of core learning principles, and we're going to look at a couple of principles this week. The first is the notion of practice and feedback and what role it plays in the learning process. I'm reminded of a lot of recent conversations on the so-called flipped classroom approach to teaching. What is the flipped classroom? I hear this too sometimes. So if you think of a kind of traditional science class, students would get their first exposure to the concepts during class, usually by lecture, and then work through those ideas and apply them in different ways after class through problem sets and homework and things like that. In the flipped classroom, you kind of shift that order around so that the student's first exposure comes before class, either by reading the textbook or watching instructional videos. And then they do the kinds of things that used to be in their homework, but they do them in class with each other so they can get feedback from each other and from their instructor, usually through some group work or cooperative learning activities. And really, I think one of the things that the flipped classroom discussion does is it highlights the important role of practice and feedback in the learning process and takes that from something that happens outside of class where students are on their own and moves it to a more central location in the learning process.
The other core principle we're going to be talking about is motivation. Now, Derek, when I was an undergraduate, I was in engineering, and I had a serious case of imposter syndrome. Essentially, I assumed that everybody else knew way more than I did, had more intrinsic talent and more ability than I did. So I worked twice, three times as hard to achieve what I thought was the same level of performance. And so that really speaks to my motivation as an engineering student. And to the importance of that in my persistence in my degree. It really highlights how important it is that our students have that kind of motivation in order to overcome any kind of barriers that they would have to performance and deep learning. So one question we're going to ask this week is, how do we better foster high levels of motivation in our own students?